Okay, the one thing you should never do is read Facebook comments on politically charged news articles. Think of it as the same rule as not feeding your mogwai after midnight. For the exact same reasons. I'll explain in a moment. Welcome to Blog Oklahoma. As those of you who follow me on Twitter and Google Plus know, I'm not a fan of Facebook. If I didn't have to, I wouldn't use it. But Facebook has pretty much woven itself into the fabric of the modern internet. I have family, friends, and clients that exclusively use Facebook. I have services that require a Facebook login. News websites use the Facebook commenting system. And yes, I maintain a presence on Facebook for Blog Oklahoma. Now, I can go off on a rant just about Facebook, but you know what? We're going to save that for another time. In this episode, I'm going to talk about the experience I've had over the last few historic weeks regarding Facebook comments. Now, I'm bending my own rules a little bit regarding this podcast because I'm going to bring up those topics I would typically avoid, religion and political opinion. You know, the same topics you wouldn't bring up at a family reunion. I felt strong enough that I wanted to bring this to your attention in the hopes that maybe you and I together can bring some civility back to commenting in general. But as fortunately the way the world's working right now, I seriously doubt that's going to happen. The one thing you should never do is interact with Facebook comments on politically charged news articles. Think of it as the same rule as not feeding your mogwai after midnight, you know, from the movie Gremlins, for the exact same reason. I made a mistake. I interacted on a news article, and Stripe got into the leftover chicken. Wasn't pretty. The recent United States Supreme Court's ruling about marriage equality and the Oklahoma State Supreme Court's ruling about the Ten Commandments monument needing to be removed from state capitol grounds has brought out the worst in Oklahomans within Facebook comments. I'd like to point out that I agree with both of those rulings. And I stated so on the news articles with Facebook comments. Oops. There are those who are polite, express their opinion, and move on. If Facebook comments were full of these people, the world would be a better place. There are those who share the facts, mostly without comments. If Facebook comments were full of these people, the world would be a better informed place. But no. Facebook is full of derisive comments. It didn't take long for people to start exchanging insults, getting quite personal, and many were caught in the crossfire. You might find a few threads here and there where there was a civil debate, but for the most part, it was an all-out flame war. I want to point out that there was derision from all sides, but it was overwhelmingly from the far right of the political spectrum. And here's the part that leaves me a bit heartbroken. I have to say, the worst of the worst of the worst of the comments came from so-called self-described Christians. I say so-called because there is no way these people represent the faith that I learned in Sunday school and hold very dear. Anyone who had a differing opinion was a leftist, devil-worshipping, socialist atheist. Now, there's a whole lot wrong with that ignorant statement that we can go into, but let's skip it and go on. These same people were making declarations that the state of Oklahoma and America were going to hell. This is not what the Bible teaches. America was founded as a Christian nation. We should impeach the Supreme Court. We should change our Constitution. And finally, the talking point of the hour, this violates my religious freedom. There were many who tried to educate these sad people by sharing the facts about the cases, what each ruling was based on both within the United States and state of Oklahoma's constitutions. Some gave history lessons about the founding of America. Some even shared Bible verses about loving thy neighbor and providing counterpoints and corrections to misused and overused scripture quotations. None of this worked, of course. It just ramped up the vitriol. Oh, and the light help you if you'd use the rainbow overlay on your profile picture. You were especially targeted with hate-filled remarks. I should know. I was not immune to this either. I used the rainbow overlay on my Facebook profile picture because I was happy for my friends and neighbors and wanted to show my support. I received some, let's say, insulting remarks. Luckily for me, though, I've been through this. I've been managing forums, comments, and other services for some time, and I've dealt with all manners of gremlins, trolls, and asshats. I've always, when I hit onto a social network, it's a good policy to learn where the block and report buttons are. You're going to use them a lot. Now, I'm not immune to knee-jerk reactions. I've been known to leave a comment or two, but I try to temper what I write down. Once a flame war erupts, sometimes it's hard to get out of it. The best advice I can give is just let it go. You've made your point. Move on. Let it go. This kind of uncivil discourse is not exclusive to Facebook comments. Reddit is really bad about it, and Twitter can be bad about it too. What makes Facebook stand out, though, is it's not entirely anonymous. That's your name right there, and oftentimes that's your smiling picture too. If they acted the same way in real life as they do in comments, these people would probably already be in jail. You know, the real life equivalent to a block and report button. Let's just hope these Facebook comments don't get wet. Okay, now that I got that out of my system, on to other things. Oh, by the way, you should watch Gremlins and Gremlins 2. Great movies. I highly recommend them. This episode's writing suggestion. When was the last time you were involved in a comment flame war? I look forward to reading all about it. This is an exciting week for space exploration. The New Horizons spacecraft is going to do its flyby of Pluto on Tuesday, July 14th, 2015. On the very next day, the Science Channel, we're going to have a special all about it. I hope you all tune in. It's going to be great. A big congratulations to Team USA on winning the 2015 Women's World Cup. That was an awesome match with Japan. Great job, everyone. Oh, and before I forget, I fixed the slow loading problem with the Blog Oklahoma podcast Roku channel. I uploaded the wrong images for the episode thumbnails, and they were way too big. Sorry about that. If you have a Roku, please feel free to add the Blog Oklahoma podcast channel. It's currently privately listed. To install it, just visit blogoklahoma.net/Roku. Oh, and don't forget to check our show notes for the bonus links. Did you know pirate metal was a thing? And it's awesome. I'm happy to announce, as of July 12, 2015, Blog Oklahoma has 883 registered Oklahoma bloggers. Hooray! Your feedback is important, so please feel free to contact me with your comments or questions. You can get hold of me in a multitude of ways. Just visit blogoklahoma.net/contact for more information. Check our show notes for all the links and bonus material from today's episode. This has been Kevin Latham for Blog Oklahoma. Until next time.